Ladies and gentlemen, in this for gaming.com video, we're going to be talking about AMD's Polaris architecture. So I've been fairly quiet on this over the past few days, simply because of all the stuff which is happening with the next generation Xbox, also known as Xbox Scorpio, and with Amy also buggering off to Comic-Con. I just haven't had time to cover it, but today I thought it might be a good idea because an image has appeared on the internet. So this image is actually interesting for several reasons. First of all, it shows Doom running on a FreeSync monitor, which is a Lenovo Y27F. Now, just as a slight aside, this monitor is capable of only a 1080p output, but the image claims 1440p. So what's probably going on here is virtual super resolution. For those unfamiliar, you can basically think of it as downsampling. In fact, it is downsampling. This simply means that the graphics card's rendering a higher resolution than what the monitor is natively capable of, and then simply shrinks it down to fit the native resolution of the monitor. This improves graphical fidelity and is very, very impressive, especially if you're doing a high resolution display and downsampling from an even higher resolution. So for example, you could downsample from 4K to 1440p, or an even higher resolution than 4K down to 4K, if you've got the graphical grunt to do it. Regardless of all of that and semantics, it would appear that Doom is capable of running on the RX 480 at 60fps or above. Now, we don't have an exact benchmark yet, and we probably won't know full information until May 31st, which is when the Computex live stream starts at 10 p.m. EST, just for your FYI. But it does show, though, and according to the leaks, the rumors, the speculations, and all the other stuff, is Polaris 10 is capable of a sustained 60fps at 1440p. This is further evidenced by the capsation event. You might recall that, where Hitman was demoed at capsation at 1440p with everything at absolute maximum. AMD actually told me that personally during my interview with Robert Halleck recently. So I have no doubt at all that this GPU is absolutely monstrous. In fact, one can probably make the argument it's between the R9 390X and the Nano, the R9 Nano. Well, that's pretty darn impressive considering that the GPU has been confirmed inadvertently by AMD to be an X80 solution. This means that really $300 is the absolute ceiling of what you can expect the pricing to be. And the lowest it could be is maybe 250-ish. Mark. I mean, it could be slightly lower, it could be a couple of dollars here or there, but really those are the kind of the price points, and it means theoretically for the first time AMD are not going to be competing directly with Nvidia, at least until Nvidia released the GTX 1060 and lower, and AMD released the Vega lineup or the R9 490 or whatever the hell it's going to be called. With all of that said, we don't know what this particular GPU is going to be capable of or where it fits exactly in the lineup, because two reasons. One, it's RX 480, so whether AMD are replacing the R9, the R7 with simply RX, and B, whether the 480 refers to just the series and it really is an R9 480X, whether it is just the 480 and they have a higher end card, or whether there isn't going to be an R9 480X or a 480X period, we just don't know, unfortunately. What I can tell you is this card is going to be pretty darn impressive given the budget, and I'm really looking forward to it. I think it's going to be an absolutely fantastic GPU for those who are looking for 1080p, 1440p, and I think whether you're an Nvidia fan, whether you're an AMD fan, the next several months are going to be really cool for us as gamers. Let's face it, it's been a while since we've had really big graphical movements in the industry. You know, Pascal, excellent. Maxwell, it was okay. I mean, you know, it did pretty good. Kepler did pretty good. But Maxwell to Pascal, the jump is gargantuan, And how much of a jump we're going to see with, obviously, Polaris, well, we just have to wait and see. But it's looking pretty darn excellent from what I understand. So, yeah. What I'd suggest, hold on to your butts and definitely check out the live stream if you can at Computex. It's going to be a little late, I think, for a lot of folks. But it's good. I like the fact that we're getting a good smattering of GPUs at different prices, because it means that no matter your budget and no matter the display you're running, there should be something for everyone. For example, let's say that you're playing on a 42-inch TV in your bedroom or your living room, and it's only 1080p, 60fps, you don't need a GTX 1080 or a 1080 Ti, you don't need a Vega 10. You just don't. I mean, you technically, I guess you could if you want to do massive downsampling, but you just don't really need it. And so a GPU like this should keep you going for some time, in my opinion. Anyway, let me know your thoughts on this one. I'm quite excited, I have to say, over the next couple of weeks / months about what we're going to be seeing from different companies and how those GPUs are going to turn into, or rather plug into our PCs at home. Anyway, hopefully you've enjoyed the video. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye for now.